When you hear the word ectoplasm, your first thought might be that one scene from Ghostbusters.
Batman, what happened? Are you okay?
He slimed me.
But the history of ectoplasm goes back to the 19th and early 20th century, rising out of the fascinating and often bizarre world of seances. Attempts to communicate with the dead have a long history, but the classic seance, with the darkened room, the circle of people, and the dead speaking through a medium, rose to prominence in the mid-19th century. Interest died down, but then, in the 1920s, after the First World War and 1918 flu outbreak, seances spiked like never before, as survivors tried to make sense of a world shattered by mass death and conflict. Struggling to process the loss of loved ones, people increasingly turned to the world of the paranormal as a source of comfort, hoping to speak to deceased family members as a way of processing their grief. But many weren't content with just sitting in a circle and having a medium claim they could hear the voices of the dead. Notable figures like British writer Sir Arthur Conan Doyle, who wrote the Sherlock Holmes stories and lost his son in the flu outbreak, became increasingly interested in proving the existence of spirits through physical evidence, and so began a widespread fixation on scientifically verifying a substance known as ectoplasm. Coming from the Greek term ektos, meaning outside, and plasma, meaning something formed or molded, ectoplasm was a gelatinous substance that mediums claimed emerged from their mouth, nose, or other places during seances. Some said it was a kind of connective tissue between the world of the living and the dead. A nimble substance, it could, supposedly, form into the body of the dead, tapping shoulders, and even, in the spirit photography craze, popping into photos. Today, most of these photos appear obviously fraudulent, and in the early 20th century, researchers were already questioning the validity of the images. They found many mediums used methods of swallowing and regurgitating cloth or other textiles to create the illusion of otherworldly substances leaving their body. Pretty gross. Some photos of ectoplasm also depicted human faces emerging from the supposedly otherworldly substance. Once again, some were fooled. Looking closely at the photographs, however, investigators discovered the so-called faces within the ectoplasm displayed the marks of paper magazine cutouts around their edges, exposing the mediums once again as fake. Helen Duncan was perhaps the most famous medium who claimed to produce ectoplasm, and she was also the last person to be imprisoned under the British Witchcraft Act, interestingly enough. She claimed spirits of the dead materialized from her mouth, which, as you can see from the photographs, were fraudulent. Investigators discovered she made these very creepy-looking fake specters from paper masks placed on sheets and draped over coat hangers. Beyond spirits, Duncan also made claims of a ghostly hand which emerged from her nose, which psychic researcher Harry Price concluded was made of A, a woven cloth, and B, a rubber glove. Researchers exposing ectoplasm as fraudulent went beyond Duncan, however. Indeed, the exposure of fake ectoplasm became so widespread it resulted in a serious decline in physical mediums and acceptance of mediums in general. But people like Conan Doyle didn't dupe themselves en masse for no reason. Although it's hard to deny these claims of ectoplasm were fraudulent, they were responding to a very real sense of pain and loss which gripped the society, and suggesting the recently dead could still be contacted and indeed physically remain present in some form, ectoplasm was, ultimately, a strange, yet important, stage in the grieving process for many. Today, it's easy to look at these photos and laugh, or hear stories of people regurgitating cloths and feel a little sick. But it's important to remember that in the wake of a worldwide tragedy, people need something to hold on to. And strange though it might seem, in some cases, that was ghostly slime. And that's the end of our tour of the mysterious, tragic, and slightly disgusting history of ectoplasm. Thank you so much for watching this episode of Curious Archive. If you enjoyed the content, please consider subscribing and leaving this video a like. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.